Hello friends and welcome back to another Pokemon how-to guide here on the channel. My name is Lee, also known as Osiris, and in this episode we are going to be continuing on our Crown Tundra content and going after those Galarian birds. There is Galarian Moltres, Galarian Zapdos and Galarian Articuno, so we're going to be covering those in this guide right now. So to start us off, we are going to take a look at our legendary clue. So we're on legendary clue number 3. The legendary birds, the bird Pokemon of legend. When the sun reaches its zenith, it shines directly down upon a great tree with leaves that seem to burn. It is there that the legendary wings come to roost. Okay, so I'm guessing it's pretty cryptic, pretty vague, but there is a picture of a tree, so I'm gonna guess that that's where we are heading. So we'll head straight out of Fiona's hut. We'll just turn a swift left if you're facing out of Peony's hut, and we'll make our way into the giant's bed. There we go, that's the one. I was like, is it giant's bed in my head? It sounds weird, we're getting in bed with the giants. Here we go. But it is the giant's bed. This is where they sleep. But we're going for that big tree in the distance, so you can see where it is. So you've got quite a clean marker here. So we want to just be heading down this direction towards a tree, just keeping right as well, because there will be a turn off at some point where we can make our way towards the tree line. Now we need to dodge the Pokemon. In the previous guides that we've had up for the Regis and the Calyrex, I have been noting that we have, I feel like the Pokemon spawns in the Crown Tundra are way, way more than we've seen in any of the other previous games. So we come to this river here. We need to make sure that we are crossing. So I think there will be an exit route further upstream. So we're kind of doubling back on ourselves almost. Obviously trying to dodge these Pokemon. Don't know which way this Gyarados is going, but we don't want to bump into it. And then we want to come out onto the Balamal Lake. So here we are, and a nice Corviknight there for us. So let's see where the route is. Guys, this is the first time I'm actually visiting this tree. So we're doing this together. This is fresh, and hopefully it will be useful for you guys to help you out and figure out a shortcut once you've watched this and to how to do this yourself. Okay, well, we've finally made it round. We probably went the long way, but we are finally here at the tree, and we're going to trigger a cutscene right now, so we'll be able to have a look what is going on here in the game. So there is the big famous tree of the Crown Tundra. What are those big fruits on it? I wonder if they have some meaning or some sort of relation to Dynamax. And there it is. There is Moltres. Oh, and it's eating the fruits. Wow. Okay. They must be Dynamax fruit. Okay, Moltres looks angry. Okay, it's coming after us. It's coming for us. And Zapdos. Okay. Okay, this is cool. This is very cool. Okay, this cutscene is amazing. I'm probably spoiling it for you guys, but I mean, I'm so hype about this. This is like a scene from like the anime movie, like a movie or something like that. It's very cool. They've done it very well already. And there's Articuno coming in. Cool. Okay. So the birds actually appear to be kind of guarding this tree, which is interesting. And our Rotom deck's going crazy. So let's see what Rotom says about these birds. Are they going to stick around or just fly off? I'm guessing. I've heard that they're roaming. At least that's what I've heard. They roam around the area. I don't know which areas they roam in, but they're kind of heading in different areas right now. Like Articuno heading for the Crown Shrine. Zapdos heading for the Giant's Bed. And Moltres, I don't know where you're heading to. So we'll just have to have a hunt around and see where they are. But this is what this guide is for. It's helping you guys determine where these birds are, get them as easy as possible and as quick as possible on the day of release, which this is. There is pointy feathered one in the wild area, plus a fiery looking one out on the Isle of Armor. Wow. And this fancy graceful one apparently flying about the Crown Tundra. Okay, wouldn't it be something if they turned out to be the bird Pokemon I wrote that clue about? If that were the case, I think I'd call this expedition something like, here we go, wait for it, the legendary tree of legendary 3. Oh, Peony, killing it, mate. Now I've gone and ultra mega completely forgot what I called you for in the first place. Well, life's too short and sweet. The small stuff, Subtar Chief. Okay, well, I mean, he called us just to give us that title alone. These titles are great, aren't they? Jot down 3. So The bird of orange dashed off to the wild area. So that's going to be in the Galar region, even though we kind of technically are in the Galar region still. The bird of black flew off to the Isle of Armor, and the bird of purple set off across the Crown Tundra. Okay, so the first Galar bird we are going to go after is Zapdos, and that is advised to be in the wild area. So what we're going to do is fly up to the wild area. We're going to be going to the meetup spot. I think if my testing is correct, every time you fly to the meetup spot and you haven't caught this Pokemon yet, it will spawn in front of the meetup spot so you can easily locate it. And then you can try and hunt it and catch it pretty quickly. So my theory is quickly broken though here as we come out of the meetup spot and Zapdos is not here. So what we're going to do is just prove this theory and just, okay, we can't see it when we get here. Just going to fly to the meetup spot again and see if it does appear now. Okay, so we just need to wait before the sandstorm appears and just take a quick look around. And there it is, okay? We can see it just down in the corner over there. So that's where we need to be heading and we need to chase after it very quickly because it will run away, but you can catch it. You just need to keep up with it on your bike. You need to make sure that you've got all the upgrades on your bike as well, so make sure you do pay for those. It is well worth it, otherwise it's going to make getting the Zapdos in this situation very difficult. So it means your recharge is a little bit quicker, which means you can kind of make up some ground on it. You've just got to keep on top of it, and what the key to this is try and just be aware of Pokemon spawning as well and try and make some ground up on it in certain places. Like it will keep the same route when it's running around this area. So there is areas where you can kind of make ground up on it, like here. And yeah, you see, this is a good place to do it. And if we can just get one more boost, we can get it. We're gonna get it. Come on, come on, come on. Oh, we missed it. There we go. Okay, we get it. So it's not too difficult to get. Like I say, if you can't see it at first when you fly into the meter point in the wild area, just spawn back there, like fly back there and then try again. Like walk into the wild area, have a scout around. If it's not there, fly back in and then try and catch it. Try and see if you can spot it and then go for it. You're going to have to chase it. You can't creep up on it. It's not going to work. You've got to use just speed to get it. Okay, so we're going to tackle this Zapdos now. I am going to try and catch it, and we will be right back as soon as it is in the Pokeball. And we've caught it. We got it in only a few tries with a dive ball. Obviously, if you guys know me out there, I like to catch all of my Pokemon in my favorite Pokeball, the dive ball. And we've actually just managed to do it with the Zapdos. So I'm extremely happy with that. It hasn't taken too long. We got pretty lucky with it. Obviously, different balls are going to have a better chance. Zapdos data added to the Pokedex. Here we go. When its feathers rub together, they produce a cracking sound like the zapping of electricity. That's why this Pokemon is called Zapdos. Okay, so there we go. And it's a fighting flying type Pokemon, which is, yeah, that's its new typing. We want to add it to our party for sure. And we'll make way of our Tyranitar, although Tyranitar would be very good for us against something like Moltres and Articuno, really. But we'll throw Zapdos in just because it's brand new and we like to see it. So now before we move on to going after Moltres, what I will just say is that remember what I've told you, like my tips, my theory, and my testings worked out to catch this quite easily is fly to the meetup point and have a scout around the wild area there. If you can see it, great, go after it and chase it down with your bike. Make sure you've got all the three upgrades to your bike because it will make this so much easier. And then just chase it down and be aware of the spawning Pokemon that are going to try and jump out and get in your way and slow everything down. You'll be able to catch Zapdos no problem. If the Zapdos isn't there when you first fly in, you can't spot it, just walk out into the wild area, then fly back to the meetup point and then recycle until the Zapdos does appear. It's going to be in this top area of the wild area and it's going to be doing that sort of lap. So it's going to be somewhere around this area. It's not going to be in the other areas of the wild area as far as I know. Okay, we've got the Zapdos. We've just had the phone call from Peony. And now what we need to do is make our way to the Isle of Armor. Now again, like we've done with the first kind of wild area, the station, the first main station that we go to, the meetup spot in the Galar region, we're going to go to the station in the Fields of Honor in the Isle of Armor. Now this should work in the same kind of manner where when we land we are able to spot Moltres, and there you go, you see it is in the distance. So what we need to do is we just need to beat it up to the coast here and make sure that we cut it off when it flies inland, and this is going to be the quickest way for you guys to get Moltres. Okay, this is going to be the fastest way. It is going to come inland, it is going to be flying over here, you would think. It is, yeah, it is making its way inland. So there we go. And it's going to fly over. And all we need to do is get above it. And then we should be able to battle it. I think it's a little bit awkward, so we might need to go. There we go. Okay. A little bit awkward there with the ridge. But this is foolproof. You fly to the station in the Isle of Armor. The first one that you enter when you first come to the Isle of Armor. And then from there, you cut it off, you head towards the dojo as quick as you can. Once you spot the Moltres, it's always going to spawn in the same spot. Head to the dojo and cut it off before it flies over land, because then you're going to be chasing it around forever and it's going to take literally forever to do anything. I'm going to curse up first, as it nasty plots great. Okay, well, we're going to be back as soon as I've caught the Moltres, and then we'll move on to the final one of this trio. And we finally got the Moltres, so we finally got it in the dive ball as well, which is amazing. So I'm super happy about that. So the key to this is obviously flying to the station in the Isle of Armor. You will see it spawn out to sea, and you know its path. It is going to be coming over towards the dojo. You need to cut it off, so you need to get there super fast on your bike. Again, you need to have the upgrades. It's going to make it a lot easier. Cut it off there, and if you miss it or if you knock it out, just fly back to that station. It will respawn in the same spot and take the same route and cut it off before it goes over the mainland and then round the island again. So it is a dark flying type, we know this. This Pokemon sinister flame like aura will consume the spirit of any creatures it hits. Victims become burnt out shadows of themselves. So there we go, and we will add it to a party, I guess. Yeah. Okay, so what you want to do to get Articuno is fly to this spot on the map, the snow slide slope, and this is where it will spawn. Now you want to just follow it up the mountain here. You don't want to try and cut it off like you have done with the Moltres. It's a little tricky doing this, but as I say, this is a very popular spawn spot for it. There is another one that it will spawn at, but you want to just keep your distance, make your way up the mountain, because this is the best way to get Articuno right now that I know of, that I've been testing. And this has worked pretty much every time I've done it. Now, I've knocked Articuno out twice already, which is really frustrating, by accident. And we're just lucky that there's no hail at the minute in this area. If there's hail in this area, change the date, because it makes it very difficult to catch these birds with the residual chip damage. Now, it's going to just hover here. What you want to do is just stand still. It's going to pretend like it's going to spin, but it will just fly into you and attack you. There you go, you see? Every time it will do that. So there's no worries about having to guess about it splitting into three. If you go for it, it'll split into three, it'll spin around, you've got to guess one and it'll disappear. If you just stand still, it will disappear and then it'll attack you. So this is the best way to approach this. So we're going to battle this now and we will be right back as soon as it hopefully is in the Pokeball. And we finally caught Articuno. Wow, that's probably the hardest one out of all of them for me to actually capture. But we finally done it. We've got all three of the Galarian birds, which is amazing. And very happy about that. And that is all of the roaming and legendaries that we've actually been able to get now. So hopefully the guide has helped you, and the methods that we've been using in the guide have helped you actually obtain these Pokemon. That's the main reason behind these. So we've got Articuno. It is a psychic flying type. Its feathers like blades are composed of psychic energy and can shear through thick iron sheets as if they were paper. Wow, very strong bird. We'll add it to the party, and then we've got all three of the legendary Galarian birds in our party. Just make sure you come back, pick up your rewards for completing the challenges, and then that is that. So I hope you found this guide useful, hope you found all the guides so far useful, and don't worry, we have got plenty more content coming in the Crown Tundra, so do stick around for that. We've obviously got the Ultra Beasts and things like that to do, so we've got a bunch of Pokemon to look at, and lots of different facilities still to cover. So there will be more content to come. Hope you've enjoyed the early parts of it today, though. If you have, please make sure you drop a like on the video. If you do enjoy this sort of content and would like to see more of it, do think about subscribing to the channel as well. And definitely leave a comment down below letting me know what your favorite part of the Crown Tundra has been already. And we'll leave it there. So thank you so much for tuning in, friends. Have a good one, and I will see you all for another video very soon. So until then, take care and bye-bye. Yeah.